today's question is related to genetic engineering. Is genetically engineered food healthy for our body? I'm going to look deeper into the environmental part of it. So the introduction of genetically engineered food. How did it all begin? Genetically engineered food, also known as GE food, began its history to stop plant diseases, give better flavor, more nutrition, and prevent insect damages. Basically, it is developed for human and environmental benefits. However, humans have instinctively feared new things over the history. Since the first advent of GE food in the market, there has always been concerns and controversies regarding its safety and health issues. So the definition of genetic engineering is the alteration of an organism's genes to improve its characteristics, which are likely to be undesirable, using biotechnology. Food produced using this technology is called genetically engineered food. We're going to look at deeper into the benefits. There are numerous benefits of GE food to the environment that is affecting human health as well. First, the most admirable traits of GE food is its resistance against herbicides and insects, meaning it avoids the contamination of groundwater, air, soil, etc., which are caused by fertilizers and pesticides, and helps keep the environment clean. This is one of the main reasons why they prefer this. And transgenic crops have also reduced the tillage practice, protecting the soil from heat and erosion, thus saving more time, energy, human labor, and most significantly carbon emissions, because when you have tillage practice, you're likely to use vehicles to do that, which are likely to emit carbon dioxide, and it is reduced. The decreased use of insecticide improves the farmer's health, along with the consumer's health, having to avoid harmful chemicals. This is also beneficial to the environment as well, as there are less pollutants. GE crops under development will provide more nutrition, for instance, with more vitamin contents, and improve pharmaceutical compounds that they might function as anti-cancer agents and vaccines. The controversies, the worries that are faced are still there, despite the numerous benefits. Because it's statistically impossible to be have 0% of risk. So first, scientific studies have reported that the ingested DNA from GE food may flow into blood streams, which may then penetrate into the whole circulatory system. This may also affect the offsprings of pregnant humans and animals. And this also affects the environment. Ingestion of foreign and unexpected alteration of DNA composition may result in unexpected side effects and allergenicities. As the history is very short, we're not very sure of the side effects. So, and also, mutative transfer of ARM, the shortened for antibiotic resistance markers, genes into bacteria, via HGT, horizontal gene transfer, colonizing our mouth, stomach, and other organs. This means that the antibiotic resistant markers might affect our health as well. The migration of genes from GE crops to wild plants, so-called the outcrossing, may raise trouble in food safety. Also, resistance of the genes after harvest, it is very risky as well, and susceptibility of non-targeted organism from insect resistance may be affected. Loss of biodiversity and its effect to the food chain. Increased use of chemicals in agriculture. Chemicals for genetically modifying the crops. So, is it good or bad? In the last few decades since GE food was first sold, there has been many health issues. But however, this is not to state that there are none at all. Robert Goldberg, a plant biologist at SOEVER, said that such fears have not yet been quelled despite hundreds of millions of genes.
Hi, thank you very much, Surrender.